Hello friends, welcome back. So again we are continuing with the data interpretation. So we are in part number 7. After this we have one more part to do. So part number 1 to part number 8 will give you the complete syllabus on data interpretation. So this video we will be dealing with the part number 7. So before going to this part, let me request all of you, if you have not watched the previous parts, that is part number 1 to part number 6, kindly watch those parts first and then come to this video. That will be very helpful for you. And the link for previous parts are given in the description. You can watch those first. Okay. So here in this part, we are solving some questions selected from previous question papers. Okay. So let us go to the question and solve the important questions. Before going to the questions, let me request this also, that if you have not downloaded the app Trace, the learning app from Google Play Store, kindly download and download the complete sample papers, attend free live doubt clearing classes on every Sunday, and absolutely all the study materials, everything is absolutely free. So download it today and take your preparations to the next level. So let us go to the questions. So the first question is based on this graph. Answer the questions based on the birth rate of 6 different states given in the graph below. So here you can see E, S, N, G, I and C, 6 different states with rate birth per thousands given. So here you have 20 and here you have 15 and 30 and 16 and 33 and 40. All these are birth rates per thousand. And E, S, N, G, I and C, different 6 states given. Based on this, we have some of the important questions. Let us see how to solve those questions. Now you have a fair idea. The last 6 parts we have seen how to go about the questions based on graph. So the first question is, the birth rate of which state is 25% more than that of G? The birth rate of which state is 25% more than G? Here you can see G is 16. So you need not to write all these things. Mentally you can calculate and write it. So here still for explanation, let me write G is 16. We want the state which is 25% more than G. So what is 25% of G? Here G is 16. So we can say 50% means half, 8. 25% means again half. Half of 8 is 4. So the 4 more you have to add. So 20% means from with this you have to add 20%. 20% means that is equal to 4. So 25%. So that will be equal to 16 plus 4, which is equal to 20. So which state will give you a birth rate of 20? 20 we have at E. So E is the correct answer. So accordingly you can mark option C. Option C as the correct answer. Understand it very clearly. We have been asked to find out a state which is having 25% more than G. G is 16 and 25% more than G means 4 we have to add with 16. When you add 4 with 16, we get 20. So accordingly 20 comes in state E. So state E is the answer. Kindly note it, then we will go to the next question. So all these calculations you can do mentally here. Here it is 16, 25% when you add, you can add 4 here. So this will give you 20. So 20 comes in E. So directly also you can mark all these answers without wasting much of your time. So next question is, the birth rate of I is what percentage of the birth rate of E? Birth rate of I is 33 and 33 is what percentage of the birth rate of E? Birth rate of E is 20. So 33 is what percentage of 20? So you can put it like this. 33 is what percentage of 20? 33 by 20 into 100. You can cut this 20 and 100 5 times. When you multiply 33 into 5, we will get 165. So 165% is the correct required answer. Accordingly, you can mark option A. Option A is the correct answer. What percentage E of birth rate of E? I is what percentage of E? I is 33. 33 is what percentage of 20? So accordingly, you can mark option A. Kindly note it. The birth rate of C is how many times the birth rate of G? The birth rate of C is 40, and 40 is how many times the birth rate of G? The birth rate of G is 16. 40 is how many times of 16? You have to divide 40 by 16. 40 is how many times of 16? Cut this 40 and 16. You can cut it 2.5 times. If you 16 into 2, 32. Then remaining is 8. 8 means 0.5 times. You can mark it like that. Or you can do it like this also. If you are not familiar with this direct cutting, you can make it like this. Cut it with the 2 first. Here 20. Here 8. Again cut it with the 20. 2, 10 here and 4. Again cut it with the 2, 5 here and 2. 5 by 2 is equal to 2.5. So this way you will be consuming a lot of time. So directly you can practice this method. So 2.5 is our correct answer. Accordingly, 2.5 you can mark as the correct answer. C is how many times that of G? 16 is how many times of 40? Next question. What is the ratio of birth rate of I to that of S? I is 33 to that of S. S is 15. We need to find out the ratio of birth rate of I to S. I to S means 33 is to 15. This is what we need to find out. So 33 is to 15 means you can cut it with 3, 11 times. Here 3, 5 times. So 11 is to 5 is our correct answer. I to E. We need to find out the ratio of the birth rate of I to S. I is 33, S is 15. So 11 is to 15 is the correct answer. 11 is to 15, answer B. So the next question, by how much percent is the birth rate of E less than the birth rate of N? But by how much percentage, we have to find the answer in percentage. The birth rate of E, birth rate of E is 20 and less than that of the birth rate of N. Birth rate of N is 30. We have the birth rate of N is 30. So what is the difference? The difference is 10. The difference is equal to 10. So this 10 is what percentage of the birth rate of N? By how much percentage is the birth rate of E is less than the birth rate of N? From N, this 10 is what percentage? So 10 by 30 into 100. You can cut this 1 0 and the 0. Here you have 100 divided by 30. So 100 divided by 30, you will get 33.33%. So 33.33% is the correct answer. Understand the question very clearly. By how much percentage is the birth rate of E is less than the birth rate of N? Less than. What is the difference? The difference is 10. The 10 is what percentage of birth rate of N? So we got the answer 33.33%. Okay, so let us go to the next question. So the next question is based on a line graph. Here you can see the following graph shows in terms of time the distance traveled by a cyclist. Based on this, answer the following question. Here, this is given distance in kilometers and here the time in minute. From the graph, you can see the person is starting from the point A when the time was 0 and the distance is 0. And when he reaches B, the distance traveled is 0.8, and then C, then D, then E, and it goes up to 14 minutes. So based on this, we have to answer some of the very important questions. So here, the distance traveled by the cyclist at the end of the 7th minute is. Here you can see from the graph, from the 7th minute means from between 6 and 8. Here, the 7th minute. So, you can see the 7th minute, what is the distance traveled? So, here you can see the distance traveled in 7th minute will be 0 point, you can say approximately at 6 minute. At 6 minute, you can see this is 6 minute. And this is 8 minute. So, 6 minute is 0.8. 8 minute is 0.6. So, 7th minute will be 0.7. So, 0.7 kilometer is the correct answer. So, 0.7 you can mark as the correct option. So, these all are the questions directly you can answer by looking at the graph. Next question, what part of the graph shows the average speed 0.1 kilometer per minute? We have to see what part of the graph shows the average speed is 0.1 kilometer per minute. So, we have the formula, average speed is equal to what? Average speed is equal to distance traveled by time taken. So, here the average speed is 0.1 kilometer per minute. Options are given A, B. Here when you see option A, B, the total distance is 8.8 and time taken is 4 minute. So, 8 by 4, we will not get 0.1. BC, there is no change. The distance is same and time 4 to 6 minute. So, again, we will not get 0.1 minute. And CD is also will not give you 0.1 kilometer. Let us see DE. So, DE, here this DE, the distance from D to E is 2 to 0. 2 to 0 means the distance traveled will be 0.2 and time taken is from 10 minute to 12 minute, that is 2 minute. So, when you divide it, you will get 0.1. So, 0.1 kilometer per minute is the which part of the graph that shows? The answer is DE, part DE. Here, understand this distance. This distance DE, this distance is how much? 0.2 kilometer. And the time taken is 10 to 12, 2 minute. So, average speed is distance divided by time. 0.2 divided by 2 minute. So, we get the answer 0.1 kilometer per minute. So, DE is the correct answer. So, next question. What is the average speed for the first 4 minutes? What is the average speed for the first 4 minutes? So, we have average again. Average speed is equal to what? The formula? Distance traveled. The total distance traveled by total time taken. So, average speed for the first 4 minutes. For the first 4 minutes means up to here, the distance traveled is this much. So, distance traveled is 0.8 kilometer divided by time taken is 4 minute. 4 minute. So, we got the answer 0.2 kilometer per minute. 0.2 is the correct answer. Accordingly, option A, you can mark as the correct answer. Next question. Which part of the graph shows the stationary position of the cyclist? The stationary position of the cyclist means, stationary means not moving. Stationary means not moving. Not moving means the distance will not change, but the time will change. Here you can see at point at time 4 minute, at 4 minute, the distance was 8. And at 6 minute also, at 6 minute also, the distance is 8. So, from 4 minute to 6 minute, this 2 minute, the distance has not changed. The distance has not changed. That means, this is the position where the cyclist was not moving, stationary. So, BC is the correct answer. So, accordingly, you can mark option D as the correct option. Understand the concept very clearly. Whenever you draw a graph, if the cyclist is moving, the graph will be moving like this or like this according to the time. But when the time, when it is not moving, it will be a straight line. It will be a straight line like this. So that straight part only we have to find out. The straight part is BC. Straight part indicates it is at rest. It is not moving, stationary. Okay, let us go to the next question. What is the distance from the starting point at the end of the 10th minute? At the end of the 10th minute, the cyclist was at D. So at D means, what is the distance? This distance, this distance is 0.2 kilometer. So 0.2 kilometer, option D is the correct option. So these type of questions, you know, you can easily solve by looking at the graph without consuming much time. Okay, students, so with the more and more questions, we will be meeting in the next part. So part number 8 will be the last part of data interpretation. So part number 1 to part number 8, we will have the complete syllabus on the topic data interpretation. So once again, I request you, if you have not downloaded the app, Trace, the learning app, kindly download it today and take your preparations to the next level. And when you download the app, you will get a lot of free study materials, sample papers, test series, mock-up test series, and there is an option, every Sunday you can attend free live classes for your doubt clearing. Okay, so let us meet with the new topics in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.